Mai itu nanti yang penting hubungan.
Enggak nih semua. Enggak ada lagi. Enggak ada lagi.
Morning, everyone. This is the most controversial part, actually. We're going to discuss yung mga bagay that's very important with regards to music. Kanina, pinag-aralan natin yung some principles. Actually, this is my six series about music. The first one, if you would like to consider viewing it in YouTube, visit it. Just type my name, Rovel Pablo, and you will find many videos with regards to that. Especially you type Rovel Pablo and then music. Okay? So, and most of them are found in our lectures sa PYC, previous PYC. Sa PYC main. And this is somehow the sixth or the fifth. Okay, the first series that I had was Music Controversy and Ravel, and then that was developed into Rockfest, and then it went on to head through headphones. Then the next one is Heaven's Chorus, and this is the last one: Music, Your Life, Your Music. It will really reflect who are we. So once again, I invite you to bow your heads as you ask God to help us discerning what we are going to talk about this morning. Shall we bow our heads for prayer? Heavenly Father, I ask for your guidance for each one of us. This might be very heavy, but we know, dear Lord, when we love someone, we will really choose what will be pleasing to him or to her. Help us to be enamored after this session, that our music will be chosen very well. Teach us, dear Lion Father, direct our hearts this morning. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Once again, who best represents melody? Rhythm. Harmony. Rhythm. Melody. Harmony. Okay, I'm just... I'm really making sure that you understand it, huh? Because it best represents it. Now at this moment, nakapag-aral naman na tayo ng first lesson natin. Okay na ba sa inyo mag-quiz tayo? Let's have our quiz. Okay? This is our music quiz. Tell me if this music is Christian, secular, or unsure. Maybe you have it or you know it. Okay? Tell me, huh? Tell me if this is Christian, secular, or unsure. How about this song?
For the girl on the ground in the dark, every beat of her beautiful heart was a labor of love.
Christian, secular, unsure.
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 Unsure. Based on worldly standard or Adventist standard?
Based of the Bible standard.
Secular.
Okay, secular. That's a good question, sir. Okay, how about this? Secular, of course, kailangan mo memorize. How about this? Secular, ano una sagot? Unsure, secular, secular. Pangilan na ba ito? Pangatlo. Okay, pang-apat, how about this? How about that? How about that? Grabe naman kay Rovel, kailangan ko mag-memorize. How about this?
He was showing his love, and that's how he heard his name.
How about that? May Christian, may unsure? Unsure, okay. How about this? grabe naman, pero wait ka lang, babae. How about this? Of course, out of all the many, we have how many? Only two, Christian. We have unsure, secular, then Christian, and Christian. Now, let's check, no? Let's check. To tell you honestly, all of those that we played are Christian.
What?
For the standard? Let me ask this. Do we really need to have worldly standard and biblical standard?
Yes.
Really?
I mean, maybe categories are different. Sa mga na pumunta ka na sa music store.
Okay.
Maaaring nakita mo lahat yung music na yun as a Christian music. Pero, kung based ka sa biblical standard, hindi ka pasok yung karamihan sa pag-uusin.
Okay. That's a wonderful ano. Let's answer that, huh? Let's answer that. That's a very wonderful observation. How about the worldly, ano naman? Standard. In other words, if I will play religious music in a worldly setting, is it disqualified? How about that? How about when we classify things, it is easy always to exempt worldly things. I would like to drive that sincerely with you. You know what? We will go to answer that specifically, physiologically, and biblically, and even in a worldly sense. Even worldly people tells that these are very dangerous controversies. Do we really need to accept things? Now let me ask you on this. What is the difference if you are listening to worldly music on the 6 days and then on the 7th day? Sige.
Sabi sa Bible, everything na ginagawa dapat ng Christian is it's pure. Ano ba yung text sa Bible? Yep. And kung sa palagay natin, hindi siya based sa standard na yun, bakit pa natin sa tayo?
So what is really the standard? It should be the worldly or the biblical?
Biblical.
Huh?
Biblical standard.
Pero bakit meron pa rin tayong worldly standard in a sense? Oh, let me put it this way. How about listening religious music on the weekdays and then on the Sabbath day? Huh? What's the difference? Ano? Sige, ano tawag ko? Now, let me answer this. You know, my friends, actually, that's a very wonderful observation. Let me answer you according to what the music industry tells, even the worldly ministry or the worldly industry. They tell that they usually proclaim or pronounce this what we call alter ego. When we say alter ego, si Tommy ay Adventist pag nasa religious things. But pagdating na sa mga worldly things, it's another way. That's what we call alter ego. Let me put it this way. Do you know Eminem? Si Eminem siya in a real world. Pero sa music industry, ang tawag sa kanya ay Slim Shady. Si Beyonce, sa normal world, ang tawag sa kanya ay Beyonce. Pero pagdating na sa ano, she's called as Sasha Fierce. Ngayon, sino papaniwalaan natin dito? Is it the natural or the alter ego? No, as if parang we will be Adventist in some sense and then not Adventist in some sense. Half-Adventist. Then, gusto ko kasi i-clarify yung mga bagay na kasi this is very controversial. It needs to be clarified with especially young people. The young people is the main target of the enemy with regards to music. Tatandaan nyo, Satan is the master musician in heaven. And if he knows how to deceive angels, what do you think? What do you think would be our exemption as human? we could not be deceived. There's a great challenge there. But the main point here is this. Always remember, it should be something that will prepare us as individually, distinctly. Sinabi ng Romans 12 verses 1 and 2, do not be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. These are the dangers in the Christian world. These are people who are having this band, Christian rock and roll bands, and then they have one of their crews observe these people. These are great people. And you know what? According to Crystal Mayer, she is a Christian singer, huh? This is a Christian singer. She said, how about the many huge Christian bands? I have toured with the Smoke Pact and have sex with women and men who are not their husbands and wives. How about the hundreds of Christian bands I have been around that watch South Park and cuss like sailors? How about the Christian bands that look at pornography? So can we say then that in a worldly sense, they really, what they call the fact? If they are doing this, they are right? Or in the Christian sense, they are doing wrong. But doing what is right, it is the worldly standard. Could we consider that way? Okay, so now I would like to see even more, no? Si Tony Campolo, this is very, very striking, no? He said here, this is Christian Music Encyclopedia, Volume 5. He said, being in the back room with many of these famous groups, you could discuss many of these famous groups who are in the Christian era having this rock and roll band. And I know you have things in your mind in which I have been listening to many times ago. And that influenced my, what? My music in the religious realms. Thinking that I could make it right when I go to God in His presence doing all those music. He said here, being in the back room with many of these famous groups before they go on stage is absolutely frightening. Why is it frightening? The ego trips they are on. So what are these ego trips? They are religious on this side and then they are not religious on this side. The language they use to hear their for others when show time comes, or ibig sabihin pag nag-ano na sila, nagpe-play na sila. However, they go out on stage and what do they say? Hey, aren't we together with Jesus Christ and the love we share, etc. What would you feel? In the backstage, they are just cursing words, they're having these ego trips, they are smoking pots, and then going in front of the stage, they become so religious. Let us all praise the Lord, my friends. Aren't we all together with Jesus Christ? Well, right after their ego trips, how about Jimi Hendrix? This is in the secular world. He said, we're making our music into the electric church music. A new kind of Bible. A Bible you could carry in your heart. One that will give you a physical feeling. We try to make our music so loose and hard-hitting so that it hits your soul hard enough to make it open. We want them that our music is just a spiritual as going to church. Listen to those words. And then another one, Frank Zappa. He said in Life Magazine, June 1968, the way in which sounds affects the human organisms are myriad and subtle. What does it mean by myriad and subtle? It's really what? Parang di mo naman malayan. Di mo naman malayan, it's really affecting us. Listen to the next words of Frank Zappa. The loud sounds and bright lights of today are what? Are tremendous indoctrination tools. Let me put it this way. Every music is a 3-minute sermon. Whether it might be in the secular, might be in the Christian, might be love song, or might be popular song, it is a sermon. Why? Because they are proclaiming messages. Now, let me ask you. Even you will preach here 1 hour, but you will have a beautiful song for 3 minutes. Which of those will you be blessed? The message or the music? It's much more with the music because it proclaims a message that carries people. And can you just imagine that these people are in the worldly realms, in the worldly business, in the music industry, they are what? Having indoctrination tools for each one of us. Another one is Dr. Michael Bala, Music and the Mind. He said like this. Listen to these words. The human mind, what? Shuts down after 3 or 4 repetitions of our rhythm. Now, let me give an example. Okay, let's just try this. You create a rhythm. First rhythm. Second. Third. So it already shuts you down. How many here would like to stop that beat? It will somehow be myriad and subtle. But you will already be carried away. It's just the 3 and 4 rhythms, repetition of rhythm. And how about those music and say, they will just repeat their lyrics again and again. I will sing of your love forever. I will sing of your love forever. I will sing of your love forever. I will sing. What does that mean? That is hypnotism. That is the way of hypnotism. If the 3 or 4 rhythms or repetitions of rhythm or a melody or harmonic progression, it could already what? Shuts down our minds. How could this be? How could we really help ourselves if we are listening to this kind of music? Si Juanita McElwain, PhD, retired chair po siya ng music therapy department in Phillips University. She said, rock style bypasses the frontal lobe and our ability to reason and make judgments about it. This music, like television, can produce a hypnotic effect. Is it communicating something to us? If there's a musician behind music, what do you think is the one? Who do you think is the one who's controlling also this kind of hypnotism? God would not like you to love him by force. God wants a real-hearted relationship with him. Pero kung it is by force, it's very dangerous. Now, this is the question of Luis. Can music alone influence the listener? Can music alone influence the listener without any lyrics? So what then is more important, lyrics or music? Okay, let me give an example. Okay, tell me what you feel when you hear this music. Wow, it affects us even without lyrics. Tama? And can you just imagine, kung dagdagan mo pa ng lyrics, kaya ganito nangyari po, no? The devil will always like to play with the harmony or the music, tapos hindi niya na, ano, ipapapansin sa atin kung anong laman ng lyrics. That is way. He will distort the sequence. The rhythm goes first, and then the harmony, and then the melody, you will not recognize it anymore. Like the songs of Blue. Are you familiar with the songs of Blue? Oh, good. Now, have you noticed that these songs are promoting something else? Let me tell you that they have stimulation with regards to music. And these are people who are really prominent in music. Listen to this. I forgot the name. He's a top musicologist, top conductor also of the 20th century. He said, "The music I hear in your churches are what? Sex and anger." Bakit? Why sex and anger? Because it's usually what? Perversive. Parang seducing. Now let me give you an example. Yung mga nag-glide-glide na words, yung mga nag-glide-glide na way na pagkanta. Amazing grace. That is somehow a sensual way of what? Of notes. And what makes it what? Anger. Yung mga rhythm na tan 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 tan. Anger. You will really what? Have anger with those things. Now, who among you here have listened to rock and roll that will not really express something with anger or somehow parang bitterness on something? I do anything just to hold you in. How do I look like? Now, my friends, listen to Robert Shaw. I don't know if the church today understands the music brought into the church. The people don't understand the music. It is what? Perverse. It is perverse. Alam niyo po ang problema natin sa music is this. We just don't really sing it accordingly. Tama? When we sing the song, praise Him, how do we sing it? Sige. Give a try. Praise Him, praise. Sorry. Sige daw, can you try the pitch? Praise Him. Now tell me, how is it really connecting how you praise God? It should really what express it. Kaya pala, instead na wait the song, change the song na lang. Change the song. Kasi hindi siya naging appropriate. Yung sasabihin natin, Jesus paid it all. Pero pag kinanta natin, para bagang hindi binayaran ang Panginoon lahat. Jesus paid it all to Him I owe. His I left the crimson stain. He worshiped white as snow. Okay naman, di ba? Pero umaatma ba siya doon sa kinanta ko? So pag sinabi mo, don't forget the Sabbath. Anong way natin kumata? Don't forget the Sabbath. Appropriate po ba siya? Now let me ask you. Alam nyo, ganito no? If you are really enamored with Christ, this is what will happen. Kung si Ronel, meron siyang iniiro, meron siyang iniibig. Siyempre, ang pipiliin niyang music para dun sa babaeng yun, it should really be the best quality. It should really be the best quality that will be glorifying God. Now, let me give you an example. Pipiliin niya ba yung pipitsugin lang na kanta? No. Tama? Pero bakit hindi natin magawa sa Panginoon? Because we are not really enamored with Christ. That is why when we go to the church, our music is somehow what we call tepid song. Yung tepid, yung parabagang wala talagang nagawa ang Panginoon sa buhay natin. When we sing it with our heart, sing it with our joy, feel and know the emotion of the song, it will really give its right expression. Listen to what they are saying. The great strength of rock and roll lies in the beat, It is a music which is basically what?
Sexual
and Puritan. Billy Joel, he said, music is essentially the manipulation of sound. It has the power to arouse, it has the power to frighten, and listen to these words, and has the power to make people what? Profane. You know, all those things they were saying about what? Rock and roll. In the early days, he said, ooh, it's gonna subvert our youth. It's gonna make them all wanna have sex. It's gonna make them all crazy. They were right. All right, rock and roll. Is it connecting something? Isn't it familiar? Isn't just a coincidence that those words are being used? Being used. That's why no wonder Verne Bell, she said, one of the most powerful releases of the fight or flight adrenaline high is music, which is discordant in its beats or chords. Bakit kaya? Bakit? Let me give you an example. Kung meron bang horror, ang gagamitin mong music ay Rockabye Baby? Dun, 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 dun. Would that be appropriate? No. The devil will really play with it. Good music follows exact mathematical rules. Listen to this. Which causes the mind to feel comforted, encouraged, and safe. Musicians have found that when they go against three rules, the listener experiences what? An addictive high. As in all addiction, victims are becoming intolerant. This is a powerful drug. Music is a very powerful drug. Who among you here listen to, or let me put it so, who among you here have tasted veggie meat? Okay, we are really Adventists. Veggie papa. What makes it veggie?
Components.
No protein, no man. Parang, ewan ko ba, no, bakit? Now, if you will take away the veggie, what do you have? Tapa and meat. Now let me put it this way. Who among you here are listening to veggie hip-hop? Veggie rock and roll? Okay. Okay. Let me put it this way. It is rock and roll, but we consider it as good for us. When you take away the veggie, what do you have with you? Let me put it this way. You go along, you hear listening to Christian pop music. Christian rock and roll. That's the same way. When you take away the word Christian, you have the main thing. Not because it have Christian in it, that will make us holy. That will what? That will make us righteous. Hindi dahil nilagyan mo yan ng Christian sa umpisa niyan, that will really be appropriate for every Christian. I hope that is very clear with which each one of us. Everywhere you look around the world, people are using drugs to alter consciousness. What is in the drugs? I have discovered along with many others the extraordinary power of music, particularly percussion, to influence the human mind and body. This is Mickey Hart. Kung titignan niyo si Mickey Hart, yung upuan ninyo, hindi pa yan sapat sa drum set na meron siya. Nakapalibot yan sa kanya, may cymbals, and can you just imagine he's playing all those things at the same time? He's really one of the best drummers ever. There have been many times that I have felt that the drums have carried me on to an open door, to another world. My tradition, rock and roll, have a spirit side. That there was a branch of the family that maintained the ancient connection between the drum and the gods. Now let me ask you something. How would you really discern what is right and wrong music? If music best represents who God is, melody represents God the Father, harmony represents God the Son, rhythm represents God the Holy Spirit. What do you think is the appropriate music for each one of us? Who among you here knows the devil's signature? The devil's signature is a signature in which when you recognize it, you know that it is of the devil. This is the devil's signature. Listen to this rhythm. Sino sa inyo hindi mapapasayo dyan sa rhythm na yan? Pero may na, steady lang kayo, walang nangyari sa inyo. Walang nag-move sa inyo na sumabay. There must be a problem. Now, what have you noticed with the rhythm? Bakit kaya ganun ang rhythm? For us to understand that, the way of the devil is to distort the human rhythm. Let me ask you, who among you here knows this one? Now, let me ask you. I would like to discuss this with you because according to what I've learned and according to my experience, you know, let me just give you a short testimony. When I left rock and roll world, talagang iniwan ko siya ng derechahan. Walang menon-menon. Tinanggal ko siya agad. You know what happened to me? It gave me palpitations. Nagkakaroon na ang palpitations na talaga I'm grasping my breath. Nahirapan na huminga. And there are times na kusang bumabagsak na lang ako, nahihilo ako because of my palpitation. That's because of my music. You know what happened? One time sa Sampaguita Hall, sa AUP ko yun. Pagdaan ko pa sa Sampaguita Hall, I heard a song of Paramore. And that is our rock and roll song. And then, nung narinig ko siya while having my palpitation, nawala siya. Nawala yung palpitation ko when I heard the song. What is the connection of the music and my heart? Don't you know that the heart is the center of all the rhythms of the body? It is the center of the rhythms of the body. Kung i-distort natin ang rhythm ng body, what will happen to us? It will really what? React on an opposite way. Are you following? Kaya pala, gusto mo na masanay sa mga ganitong rhythm kasi ganun na nga ang pinapakain natin sa puso natin. Now, let me ask you, what is the sound of the heart?
Love.
Now, let me ask you. Diba? Love. If you will hear it, ano ang malakas doon, yung love or yung dove?
Love.
Why love? It's the first pump. Love. Actually, you will hear the systolic and diastolic at the same time. But you will find it on the same way, it goes with that rhythm. Love. Now, let me put it this way. Kung nakarinig kayo, love. Appropriate ba siya sa atin? No. Kasi ang tamang rhythm ng puso natin ay love. Now, let me put it this way. Kung dinidistort mo ang rhythm ng puso, what will happen to the body? It will react according sa naririnig niya. Are you following so far? It will react according sa naririnig niya. Now, if the rhythm of the devil is now, love is the sound of the heart. And you calculated it that love is the strongest. Now let me ask you, if you will count it into four, love, what numbers are strong? 1, 2, 3, 4.
1 and 3.
Why 1 and 3? The love, no? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what kind of rhythm do you hear? Pump. This is the rhythm that you could hear on this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 3. You are? Sino sa inyo napapasayaw sa ganyang rhythm? Bakit hindi ka makasayaw sa ganyang rhythm? bakit hindi ka talaga makasayaw sa ganyang rhythm? It's not really appropriate. Not unless kung ibahin mo yung rhythm. Tama? Not unless kung ibahin mo yung rhythm. Now let me tell you, this is how the devil plays with our heart. How the devil plays with our rhythm. Now, let us try this one. Let us clap our hands. Let us clap our hands and then count 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop. Let's try to count in the 1 and the 3. Tell me what you feel, huh? Tell me what you feel. Ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop. What do you feel? Okay lang or may distortion? Naku, may problema ang puso natin. Ano, okay lang siya, hindi? Huh? Oh, let's try, no? Let's try sa 2-4. Kung saan na mas tumitigil. Okay, try natin yung 2 and 4. Ready, go. 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, the 2 and the 4. It is the devil's signature. Sure. Let me put it this way. Kaya pa na napapasayaw tayo kasi yung physiological effect ng katawan natin, it really needs to go with lockdown. Lockdown. Pero kung binaligtad siya sa lockdown, 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 kailangan niya mag-react in a way na lockdown, 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 lockdown. Tama? Pero pansin mo kung 1 and 3 siya, yung marching, it will always help you think. Sanang left, tama? Sanang left? Now, if you will go with the 2 and 4, mag-iisip ka pa ba kung nasan yung rhythm? No. It will just be subtly what? Hypnotizing us. Pero ang Panginoon, He really wants us to think very well if we are in the right rhythm. If we are in the right rhythm. Now, let's try this one. Okay? You clap in the 1 and the 3, and then I will create the rhythm, drum, marching. Okay? Ready? Try it. 1 and 3. Ready? Go. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let me ask you, may na-feel ba kayong pressure? Wala. Kasi yun ang normal na rhythm ng katawan. Are balanced so far. But if we'll try this rhythm, how about this? Sino-sino mo mag-marching na kanya? Babagay ba siya? No, it could not be. How about this one? Ano nakikita nyo? Simple lang ng difference ng rhythm ng Panginoon at rhythm ng kaaway. It's just a matter of counting it. How about this one? Can you just imagine our church going with this rhythm? 4, 1, 2. Diba? Come on! Let's praise the Lord! Now, how about this? I don't think so. Am I communicating something here, Natalie? If you really like to know what is the right rhythm, you need to count it if it really goes with the 1, 3, or 2, 4. Now, how about examples like, give me for, simple, How about this, no? Let me just give you an example. Different, ano siya, no? Iba-iba yung music niya, pero it's the same song. Listen carefully how they distorted it. How about this song? Okay. How about this song? It's having a problem also. Now let me give you an example. Let's try this one. See? Let's see. Let's try this illustration. On the other side is the photo, and then the other side is the words. Here are the words. How about if you have spiritual photo, mayroon kang picture ni Jesus Christ, tapos mayroon kang words na, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Is it a good picture? Huh? It is a good picture. How about this? You have a spiritual photo, you have Apostle Paul, and then you are talking about mountains or talking about things that has been experienced by Paul. Is it appropriate photo? Is it still a good photo? Yes! It's okay, tama? It's still okay. But how about this one? You have a spiritual photo, you have the 12 disciples, and then ang words mo ay cursed words. Is it appropriate? The picture could not sanctify the words. Are you following so far? How about this? You have a carnal photo, and then you have spiritual words. Like we have a lady who is toot, and then you have the words here. The bed is one. That is spiritual. Is it a good picture? It's very carnal. How about this one? Okay, it gets worse and worse. You have the carnal photo, and then you have a non-spiritual and a carnal photo. And even so, with the carnal photo and then you have a curse words, it's still appropriate. Or it's appropriate with the words and with the photo. Are you following so far? Nakakakonek pa ba tayo? Nagkakakonek pa ba tayo? Yes, I know that you could really guess this one. Let me put it this way. Kung sakali, ako pastor. Pastor ako, tapos makikita mo yung forma ko ay pangkista. Is it appropriate with me?
No.
Bakit? Pastor naman ako. Bakit siya hindi appropriate? Hindi umaakma yung damit ko, yung suit ko sa pagka Ako. Now let us try music. In music, why don't we try this one? You have a spiritual music and then you have spiritual lyrics on it. Is it a good music? Yes, absolutely. How about you have a spiritual music and then you also have a non-carnal or non-spiritual, yung neutral lang na lyrics. Is it a good music? Like the mountains, the rivers, the flowers, is it a good music? Yes. It's still okay. How about this? You have a spiritual music and then you have a carnal lyrics. Ang music mo ay ano? Amazing Grace, pero lyrics may mga mura. Is it a good music? Bakit? Religious naman yung tinutugtog ko. Would the music sanctify my lyrics? How about this one? You have a carnal music and then you have a spiritual lyrics on it. You are playing rock and roll, yet you have Jesus Christ, Jesus lyrics on it. Is it a good music?
No.
About it, no. Lyrics ko naman, ang ganda. Ano po? Wala sa?
Sir, ka naman sinabi mo kanina, dapat yung totality, harmony, and freedom natin.
Yeah. Okay. Now, ganito ngayon natin. Ilag ni po this way. Yung way ko magtugtog ay rock and roll. Pero, ang sinasabi ng lyrics ko ay mga mura. O let me, di pala ba mura? Spiritual. Biblical siya. Is it a good music? Let's praise the Lord. Is it a good music?
No.
Bakit? Because it is not what? Sanctifying the lyrics could not sanctify the music. When in fact, many of us fall on that level. Are you following so far? I need to make this clear with you because wherever we may go, music will always be an issue. Music will always be an issue. If we do not know where to stand, what will happen for us? What will happen to us? Of course, the list goes on. You have a carnal lyrics or carnal music and then non-carnal spiritual music. How about the song, There Is None Like You? Are you familiar with that song? There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. Is it religious or secular? Help me now. I could search for all eternity and find there is none like you. Religious or not? Ano nangyari? Ha? Let me put it this way. It is a dual meaning song. You could say it to a loved one and you could also say it to God. Is it appropriate music?
No.
Of course, it is not. It could not. It is not jiving well. It's not jiving well. The same thing with this. Kung carnal music siya, may carnal lyrics siya, appropriate siya. Kasi talagang matma siya, tama? Let me put it this way. Why don't I try? Tell me, what do you feel when I say this one? I love Jesus. What do you feel?
I love Jesus.
Is it good? Or not? Okay lang, di ba? How about this? I love Jesus! I love Jesus! Guy! Maasar ka ba, di ba? What? Parehas na naman sinabi kong lyrics. Ano ba malit sinabi ko? Yung way ko mag sabi nun. Kahit na sabihin pa sa'yo, I love you, pero yung way mo naman nagpabalagpag, pabagsak, it is not what appropriate. So let me put this way. How about you are having this rock and roll and then you have a Christian lyrics on it? Is it appropriate music?
No.
No, because it is not what? Appropriate. It is not according to the lyrics and the music itself. It's not according to the lyrics and the music itself. Mas iba pa, liwanag ko po na mabuti sa inyo. How about, let's try some action songs. Tell me, kung appropriate yung lyrics ko do sa music ko. Okay? Why don't we try this one? These are young people music, no? Sa children pala. King of kings and Lord of lords, glory, hallelujah. King of kings and Lord of lords, glory, hallelujah. Jesus, Prince of peace, glory, hallelujah. Ano nangyari? Is it appropriate?
No.
Ano yung kinalaman na ulit-ulit ko doon sa lyrics ko? Eh parang ko wala akong words. Ano pagkaintindi niyo sa akin? Pero kinakanta natin siya. Kinakanta naman kabataan. Is it appropriating with my body language? No. Action songs are different with dance. Ang dance ko mga kapatid, it is a song with steps. Pero action song, it is a song that will be acted. Ang tanong, para kanino ba talaga action song? Para sa normal? Actually, it is a special music for special people who are deaf or mute. Hindi nga nila maintindihan yung sinasabi natin tapos kung ano na pang ginagawa natin. Ay paano? Aysa. No, let me ask you. Ano yung mga lyrics niya? Ano yung lyrics niya?
Aysa.
1, 2, 3, what? Sige, sabi niyo sa akin lyrics. 1, 2, 3, fisherman. Who's the first one?
Abraham.
Tanong, kailan naging fisherman si Abraham? Have you noticed that? Kasi ang ginagawa lang po natin, ini-entertain lang natin ang AY thinking that is really appropriate in the sight of God. Yo, yung gaganon-ganon tayo na, J, kop. Di ba? Parang tayo, ano, sabi natin walang lyrics, ha? Sasabihin siguro ng mga bingis, sasabihin ng mga bingis, ang ginagawa ng mga dentist na to. Sabi nila, di sila sumasayo, pero ba, yun yung kanta nila. May mga kanta pa na tayo na, So, ganun, no? Anong connection of deep down in my heart, face to face, shoulder to shoulder, back to back, younger and older, minsan matutuwa pa. Is it entertaining or is it worship? When we start entertaining, we are ending, we're stopping worshiping God. When we stop entertaining, we're starting worshiping God. Am I communicating something here? Upon Father Abraham, as many sons, right arm, left arm, right foot, left foot, cheek, up, turn around, as many sons. Meron pa diba may, meron pa ano sa dila, ang tanong. Kung ang bingi at pipet tumingin sa atin, ano sasabihin nila? Bakit ba ganun yung mga Adventists? Anong kinalaman ng song mo doon sa action mo? Eh paano yung ano? Ito talagang favorite ko to. Alam yung kanta na ano? I'll be riding my horse when Jesus comes. Anong chorus nyo doon? Paano ang chorus nyo? Ibiyaya yan, paano yan? Yung sa amin kasi gano'n, Ibiyaya. Ganda, di ba? Ganda, napaka-appropriate. Now, can you just imagine, no? The clouds are getting brighter. Tapos nakita mo, naging glorious ang clouds. Tapos yung ting dumadating si Jesus, sa sarang gabi mo, Ibiyaya. Jesus is coming, Ibiyaya. Ang masaklap pa doon, may part pa doon, I've been clapping my tongue. Can you just imagine Jesus is coming? I'll be cracking my... Tumatawa tayo. Pero yung usual yung ginagawa natin. Tama ba? Am I communicating something here? Ano po ang dapat? Dapat nag-appropriate yung lyrics natin sa music natin, sa body language natin. So, I'm happy today. Be Jesus Christ, I'm happy. Kahit bingi, kahit pipi, nakapag-minis ka pa. Tama? Pero kung nag-entertain lang tayo ng worship, wala talaga tayong mapapala. Ang hahanapin ng mga tao, sa mga kabataan sa church, yung mga bagay na nag-entertain. Rather that will really give right worship to God. I hope I'm speaking something clear. Tatanda niyo po mga kapatid, it should be appropriate with our body language. So, What is the main point here? Our music should always be appropriate where God is glorified. Marami tayong mga music that it seems to be parang very trivial na lang. But we don't go back with the Word of God. Philippians 4:8 expressed something. Ephesians 5:19 and 20 express something that is very important. If we are failing with music, let us go back with His words. Let us go back with His words. At nangyayari na lang po sa atin, ina-adapt natin yung music ng ibang tao. Kaysa tayo nagre-reach out sa kanila, tayo ang i-re-reach out nila. Tama ba? Ang kinakanta natin, when the music fades, all is changed. Anong rhythm? And simply come. Kahit anong gawin mo, 2-4 talagang rhythm ng Heart of Worship. Tapos tingnan mo pa yung lyrics niya. When the music fades, all is what? All stripped away. And it simply come. Longing just to bring that something that is of worth, that will bless your heart. Pero pasin yung refrain. I'll bring you more than a song, for the song itself, it's not what you have required. Tama ba yun? It's not what you have required. Tapos i-justify natin, you search mas deeper within naman eh. Nababasa mo naman ang puso ko. So, okay lang yung music ko kahit na ganito. But you know what? It's time that we will really justify things. It will really be hard for us to glorify God in our music. Matthew 12:25 says, everybody that's against within itself could not stand. Could not stand. Who among you here are Adventists? I would like to make a sincere call with you here. Who among you here are really Adventists? You're really waiting for the coming of Christ. When people will listen to us, could they still see the distinction of what Adventist is wherever they may be? Could they see Adventist in us? Or hindi na rin tayo na iba sa mga tao? Let me tell you this, my friends. Kung hindi tayo na iba sa mga tao, sa tingin nyo pagdating ng Sunday law, sino hanapin nila? Adventist, tama? Pero ang tanong, kung kahit sa music natin, sa pananamit natin, hindi tayo naging Adventist, sa tingin nyo, pupuntahan ba nila tayo? Pupunta sila, ay, Adventist pala yun? Akala ko si born again, born again naman ang Adventist, yan pala naman. The point here is this, God really wants to preserve distinct people in the end times, who will really raise the banner high for the glory of God. Whether you will do it for a man, or for the church, let it all be done only for God. And let it all be done for God, if through a people, through a person, let it all be done by God. Because I believe there is no other basis in music than what it is really glorifying in the presence of God. Let me put it this way. If I'm worshiping here, and I know the presence of God is here, I am religious when seventh day comes. But when I go once again to the world, I am also religious. Do you think God will listen to your music when you go to that music? Tell me now. If the Savior stood beside us, would we really do the things we do? If I'm playing this music for the woman, is it a love song or is it a song of love? Iba po yung love song sa song of love. Baka mamaya, song, nagpa-pretend lang siya sa love, pero di siya umaakma sa love. Love song ba? Pag sinabi mo stupid love, crazy love? All you need is love? Am I communicating something? But when we go back to the principle that we are doing this for the glory of God, we will make sure that everything we listen to is all for the glory of God. At this moment, I would like to end the note with that. And I hope that there will rise an Adventist people. When we claim Adventism, it should really be proclaimed for us. Now, I forgot to give an example. Last example, mga kapatid. How about you have the rhythms of the guitar? What would happen if we will go with 2-4, we will go with 1-3? I tell you, my friends, konti lang ang diferensya na makapag-create tayo ng something that is offbeat. Let me tell you this. How about this? Appropriate with us. What makes it inappropriate? You read it. What is with the rhythm? Whether we like it or not, it's creating something different. How about this? What is the problem with the song? Is it the song? There's no problem with the song. It's just the rhythm. I'm not saying that the music that we're listening to are wrong. It just needs to flow with the right principle. Now, ang sabihin ay babagay natin siya sa kalwalhatian ng Panginoon. How about your Ravel, plucking? Eh kung plucking siya, eh about kung ganyan ba ang plucking ko? How about that? What do you feel? Di ba ba nararamdaman yung ta-da, di ba? How about this? Sino sa inyo hindi napapano ng ulo doon? Sige, sabihin natin, wala talagang paramdam, ha? How about this? Wala talagang mararamdaman, wala talagang makakilos. The point there, my friends, is that it is not really according to the rhythm of your body. How about this? Sino napapasayo sa inyo? Sino napapasayo sa akin? Wala, di ba? Wala. The point here, my friends, I will tell you later on in the third part, the real essence of music in these last days. Bakit kailangan po natin paghandaan yung tamang music? Because we are in the edge of Earth's history. And if we are not prepared, I assure you, it will be very hard for us. It will be very hard for us. There might be things that needs to be taken away, needs to be left behind when we go to our relationship with God. If your music, my friends, is going between you and your God, and it is not creating an enamored relationship, better take it off. Better take it off. Produce a song that you know that it's enamoring God. Because one thing is for sure, when we do this so, when God takes control of the heart, He rules the heart. Did you catch that? When God rules the heart, He rules the heart, which is music. God is with us. We are rest assured. That is only for the glory. God bless us, and hope to see you still at the third part. Is there any question? Yes, sir.
Okay. Ano ang magandang pag-uusap na natutunan natin yung mga tama? Ang problema nito ngayon ay bakit napakarami tayong mga leader na mismo sila involved doon eh. Involved sila doon. Nakikita nila na ganito yung mga ginagawa natin. Bakit parang binabaliwala nila na parang wala silang ginagawa action na tayo ay makorek? Ito yung nakita ang problema eh. Na parang patuloy tayo natin ginagawa ito. Pero yung mga dapat na mag-correct sa atin, parang walang ginagawa. Minsan sila pa mismo yung nangunguna. Pagdating doon sa music, parang dumarating sa isip ko na parang walang karapatan na mag-praise God yung tao sa pag-gitara o sa pagtugtog kapag di mo pala alam talaga yung tamang pagbibit doon o sa mga rhythm. So ibig sabihin, mas mabuti pa pala na manahimik lang tayo kaysa sa nagparatugtog tayo dyan na mali pala yung ating mga ginagawa. Ano po ang magandang masasabi niyo kan sir?
God would lead people accordingly. Hindi basta-basta tinatanggal. We could not always look up with people. But you know what? Let me give you what the church really tells. Pero ang problema, hindi natin nagagamit. Hindi nagagamit. You know what? The church really have guidelines and philosophy in regards to music. Ngayon, brother, ano, sir? With regards to that, we could not always look up if these people doesn't really will go on the right perspective or the right principle. Maybe they know, but there are things that they could see there. I don't really know. But one thing I believe is that your personal knowledge with regards to this is more important than the corporate. Because eventually, that will lead little by little to the right principle with others. Hindi necessary na dahil ginagawa ng majority, we will go for it. Not necessary. Now, let me put it this way. Is TV wrong? No. But there are things in TV that are wrong. Is everybody, is generally, people generally are watching TV? Yes. Pero do they really know what they're watching? Not that much. The same thing with this. Ang pinaka-importante pa rin yung personal mo, conviction. Kasi kahit saan ka pumunta, ang personal mo pa rin, conviction, ang mananatili. We could not correct them, or they could not correct us. But what is for sure? When you are right with God, I assure you, He will make you right with people. When you're right with God, they will make you sure with people. One thing is for sure, sir, merong guidelines and philosophy ang church. Even the church manual is stating those things. Wala daw dapat music na nagre-release sa jazz, sa rock and roll, and any of these hybrids. It should really be glorifying God. The church manual tells that. And even in the SDA philosophy and guidelines of music, voted 2004. I don't know kung mayroon silang latest in 2010. Meron guidelines na particular with regards to that. How about yung culture nila ay ganon? Should we really go with their culture? The answer with that is this. Jesus Christ, what? Jesus Christ jived in with their culture. But if the culture goes above the Bible, It should not be. Have you noticed ganun si Jesus Christ? Kahit nakaibigan niya yung mga taong ito, pero dahil it doesn't need to go above the Bible, it should not be. Hindi kailangan mananatili yung mga bagay niya. So we should go with culture, but it should not be above the Bible. Meron lang certain extent na sasabayan natin itong mga taong ito. Kunwari Chinese, African, Indonesian, iba yung music nila, tama? But the question is, shall we really go with their culture? Naragawa. Pagdating din nun, the same question din sa kanila, yung culture natin, different sa culture na, should they go with our music? Now the question, does the Bible, does heaven promotes different cultures? Pagdating natin sa langit, bakit may African style ng worship? May Chinese style ng worship, may Filipino style ng worship. Saan tayo pupunta doon? Sa Pilipino. Ang tanong, paano siya naging langit? Kung ganun lang rin pala mangyayari sa langit. Di ba? Lahat tayo magpo-focus na talaga kung ano yung makaka-glorify sa Panginoon. Kung ano talaga appropriate para sa presensya ng Panginoon. I believe that's still the best answer, yung personal conviction mo pa rin sir. Kasi whether you like it or not, pagkatapos natin dito, marami kang mapupuntahan na may challenge sa music. Pero ang tanong kasi, hindi kasi masyadong i-share itong mga bagay. Tama? Hindi kasi masyadong i-share itong mga bagay. Now, my appeal for you, it should start for you. It should start with you. You should be the musical warrior of Bicol. It should start with you. Mamaya, explain po yung importance niya in the last days. I hope that's na sagot yun, sir. Thank you so much. To tell you honestly, I'm not really feeling good. But I thank God you made me stand even to this point of time. May last, ano tayo, may last session tayo, but this is my prayer for you. Please pray for me. I'm not really feeling good. I woke up in the past, but God made me stand. Because I know there's very important matter needs to be discussed. And that is one thing that we will bring with us in heaven. In heaven. And that will not cease. That will not stop our praises and worship. Okay, shall we all rise as we pray? Sir Ronel, pwede naman pray.
Minamahal po namin Diyos sa mong karapatan sa napaka-mahalagang lektorat ang buo sa tamang prinsipyo ng music. Napag-alaman po namin, Panginoon, na kami po ay nagulagat at lapo. Sa napakatagal na pinapanahon, kami po ay gumagamit ng mga musikal o hindi po alinsunod sa prinsipyo ng Biblia at ito po ay hindi nakapagbibigay ng kaluwan at iyan ako sa akin po nilalapit sa inyo, Ama, ang kapag-kapabataan at ito po ngayon nakapakit. Patuloy po naman ninyo kami patawarin po ninyo at sa pamukin ng pagkakalit ay mapapasimulan sa awit po ng sarili at pamukin at pamukin na sa mga tamang musika at mga pagkikay ng pamukin at sa pamukin. Tunay nga po rin noon na hindi na ang mahalaga sa lahat ay mapasimulan po namin ito sa aming pong mga personal na nawa po, Panginoon, ayon sa amin na musika po ito na bigay na kaluwalhatian sa inyo at ito po ang nakatulog upang maririba ang stress at mag-usip po ito at nakatulog sa amin upang mapalago pa po namin ang ating relationship. At sa pagpapatuloy po ng programa na PYC po ito, aming nagalami na mas marami na po ang mga kailangan na pag-usip. At ito po, Panginoon, ay nangyuntal sa aming buhay. Sa panahon na kami po ay pupunta sa aming po kanya sa iglesia, ay aking ngayon ay bahagi. Isunod pong mga taon ay marami pang mga kabataan ang siyang influensya ng PYC at ng mga kabataan ng Diyos. Ang lahat ng pagsalamat at ang lahat ng pagpupuri ay aming binabalik sa inyong panahon. At ito po ay aming nag-iinom.